I found a club in FIFA 20 to play online season with a lot of pace, which give you a big plus in matches. It's a 3-star team, so you are facing 3-star, 3.5-star teams, but with this amazing pace almost all players have in this squad, you have a really big plus to win matches. So if you want to know what team it is, stay tuned, because I'm going to show you what team, how to play with them, the formation, the tactic, the lineup, all of them. And I must say it was really, really fun to play with this team. I had a lot of fun during these matches. What I'm doing last days, last weeks in FIFA is looking for some fun to play with teams to keep myself busy. So if you are interested, please stay tuned. I'm going to show you it all. If you're new on my channel, make sure you will subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any new videos I'm posting. Videos like this, since a few weeks I'm doing an Ultimate Team series. I just started Ultimate Team, so maybe that's really interesting, because I just started and I'm going to play against clubs that are squads that are way much better than I am. So if you're interested in that or tutorial videos, all FIFA stuff, please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss anything. Please leave a like under the video if you think this useful for you, to really help me if you will do that. So the club is called Lanus or Lanus. I really don't know exactly how to speak it out, but it's a really amazing club. We have Acosta here, a really good left winger, and yeah, also the midfielders have a lot of pace, the wingers have a lot of pace, the fullbacks have a lot of pace. So I was really enjoying playing with this team. I'm playing against someone who was playing with Fluminense, the Brazilian club, and I'm in division 2, so yeah, the opponents are really good in division 2. I'm just started with playing lower rated teams, like 3-star teams. And I think the most people who are who are against me in this matches are playing for a bit longer with these teams, because it's a bit different to play with 3-star teams, because yeah, defending is a bit difficult. Everything is more difficult because the players are not that good, and if you are used to that, I think it's you have a big plus on your opponent who is playing the first time with a 3-star team. So if you are playing with this, please how do you say that? Please know that the players are not that good when you are used to play with Barcelona, with France or whatever, 5-star teams, 4-star teams. So you must know that it's a bit more difficult to play with these teams. But as you can see, we can score some pretty nice goals. We also get some goals against, as you can see here, because yeah, the defense, sometimes you need to turn quick or something and the players are not able to do that. So you get some goals against here. It's 2-0 behind, and yeah, this team was playing against Independiente, Argentina club, also 2-0. We are losing, but we have here De La Vega, our right winger. He's pretty fast, good pass, and then Moreno, the midfielder, is scoring the goal. And there it is, Moreno again to the left side to Acosta. Acosta is going into the box and he has 4-star skills, so that's pretty nice to have. To our striker is called Sant or Sant, I really don't know how to say his name, but yeah, he is one of the only players that doesn't have a lot of pace, but he is a great striker. He is good at shooting and his physics are good, so he's nice to use also. Here we have De La Vega again, back to our fullback. And this was really weird. We are in front last minute. I just messed up a few passes, and I think, well, I can't do anything about this. And then look at this, and it's the equalizer. Well, this is typical FIFA, last minute. Look what my goalkeeper, my own defender, is throwing my goalkeeper against the ground. And well, you get a goal against from a corner kick. Well, that doesn't happen a lot of times, but in the last minute it always happens. So that's FIFA. So this was a draw, but here we are playing against Real Sociedad. Real Sociedad is a 3.5, maybe a 4-star team, and we have a good start here. It's 2-0. My opponent is attacking, and what he is doing, losing the ball. We can have it to our fullback, back to the center back, looking for an opportunity to pass the ball forward. And here it is, a really lovely run from Moreno. He is our center midfielder, and look at the runs he is making all the time. It's so wonderful to have him in the squad. No, he's not a center mid, he's a cam, I must say. Then my opponent's time has come. He's going to score. Not this time has come to die, but it's time to score. His right winger, Porto, Ødegaard, really good player, good turn, and he's scoring. But we win this match. I had so much, I think I played 5 matches or something with this club and had so much fun. So I was doubting, well, I'm going to share it with you guys. We are playing a 4-3-3 attacking formation. The lineup, Rossi is the goalkeeper. He's a pretty good goalkeeper. He's not in a good form, but he saves me a lot of time. He is a really good goalkeeper. Di Placido is the right defender. And as you can see here, he has 86 pace. So that's pretty high for a 70 rated right defender. Then we have Munoz as the center back. Well, he doesn't have a lot of pace, but most center backs doesn't have a lot of pace. Valenti is the other center back, and Bernabei is the left defender. He is a left winger, but he can also play as a left defender, and with the 89 pace, he is really good there. And then we have the most defensive midfielder. It's Quignon, or so. I really don't know how to say his name, but he is the most defensive midfielder. 68 pace isn't that much, but for a central defensive midfielder, he doesn't need to have that. Then we have Vera, our central midfielder. He has 84 pace, so that's pretty much for a 73 rated center mid. And yeah, he's really wonderful as well. He can play as a cam, he can play as a left winger, but as a central midfielder with his runs, the same as Moreno, he was really useful on the midfield, especially when you are attacking. Well, the same for Moreno. You saw him in the clips I showed you before. Really lovely player, 88 pace, and he is making so lovely runs for your attack. It's really nice to have. Then we're going to the right winger. It's De La Vega. Can also play as a left winger, but he's right footed and he doesn't have a 4-star weak foot or 4-star skill move, so I like to use him on the right side. So he can cross the ball really good, 86 pace. Then we have our striker Sand. As you can see, he's already 39 years old, 51 pace, so that's not much, but his possessioning and his shooting and his physics are really good. So with the pace from the midfield and the pace from the wings, he doesn't need to have the pace. He just need to be in the box on the right time, on the right place. And he does that a lot of times, so you can score the goals with him. Then we're going to the last player. It's Acosta. He's the left winger. He's really lovely as well. 92 pace. His dribbling is good. 4-star weak foot, 4-star skill move. So you can do almost everything you want with this player. And yeah, it was really good to use. And then we are showing you the subs. Also, there are a lot of players with some pace you can use to use as a sub. Esquivel, I used a lot of times. Osqui, I think he's called. I use a lot of times, so there's a much variation possible with this squad. Then we are going to the tactics. I choose drop back because it's hard to defend with so many players that are running forward when you have the ball, and when you lose the ball you want them to go back as quick as possible, because else you are really weak on the counter attack and you don't want that. So drop back is for me the only defensive style I want to use with this squad. Then width is 3 bars, the depth is 4 bars. Then we're going to the offensive style. I choose balanced because when you are using fast build up with these players, the only thing they are doing is running forward. So when you don't have an opportunity to pass the ball, everybody is running forward. So or you lose the ball or you need to go for a long ball, and long balls with these players, they are not that tall, they are not good at heading, so you're gonna lose all those duels. So balanced is good. Some players are running forward because you instruct them to do that. I'm going to show you that later. But balance is good, so you can pass the ball around and wait for the right opportunity to pass a ball into someone who's making a good run. Then the width is 7 bars, plays in the box 6 bars, corners and free kicks both 3 bars. Then the instructions for all players, Di Placido, the right defender, the only thing I changed is overlap, so he is making runs forward because balanced attack, but not all the time. So yeah, it's just a bit of variation. Sometimes he's running forward, sometimes not. Center backs both default and Bernabei, the left defender, the same. Overlap, run types and balanced attack. Then we are going to the defenders. The most defensive midfielder, I need to say. Stay back while attacking, stay on the edge of the box for the cross and cover center. Then we are going to Vera, get forward, stay on the edge of the box for the cross and cover center. So he's making runs forward when you have the ball, but he is not going into the box because Moreno, I'm going to show you that, is already there, and all three attackers are in the box, and you also want someone on the edge of the box for the cross. When you are losing the ball, he can pick it up sometimes and yeah, pass the ball or shoot and try to score from that situation. Then Moreno, only thing I changed is get into the box for the cross. Then De La Vega, get in behind and get into the box for the cross. Then we're going to Sand, stay central is the only thing I changed, and Acosta, get in behind and get into the box for the cross. So that's it for the tactics and stuff. I hope you like it. Please leave a like under the video if you didn't do that yet, and subscribe to my channel if you are new and didn't do that yet also. So thank you very much for watching. Have a great day. Bye bye.